If you've ever looked into live streaming, you know it could be a pretty technical process. And if you're brand new to it, it could be a bit daunting. So I wanted to introduce you to an app that makes the whole process easy. The platform is called Melon, and I have a link in the description to it. And Melon is the easiest platform for live streaming, where you could live stream directly to Facebook, YouTube, Twitch, and other platforms in just 5 clicks. And probably my favorite thing about it is that you don't have to install anything. It's completely browser-based on their website. And platform is from Logitech and from Streamlabs. So this company has been around in the streaming game for a long time. So if you click the link below, you'll come to this website, and I'm gonna walk you through the whole setup process here. Very straightforward, nothing to download. Just press login right here, and you could log in with Facebook, YouTube, LinkedIn, Twitch, and Periscope, or you could use your email. Once you log in, you land on this page. You do have to give it access to microphone and webcam here, and then you'll have to press allow. Anytime you could press this lock icon to give this access to microphone and camera, I'll go ahead and press allow here. I'll press next. And I just jumped over to my webcam so I could show you the rest from here. But if you press show on stream, it will put you right here on the stream. So it's gonna use your webcam. If you have an external camera turned on here or connected, you could also use that for better quality as well. Now, before I go live, I'll show you around here. So you could at any time, obviously press mute. And then there's this option here, if you press the up arrow, where you could change your audio input. So the mic I'm actually recording onto right now is called Shure MV7, and that's the one I recommend right here. It's really nice. As long as you're close within 6 to 10 inches of it, it sounds fantastic. So I'll put a link in the description if you want to pick up an external mic. By default, it's probably set to your default internal microphone. Everything else you could leave the same. Your volume is here, and you could always reduce it here too, especially if you have a headphone. It does help with that. Anytime you could stop the video. So right now I could turn off the video here. I'm just using the camera on the Mac here, but typically I will put another video input that is higher quality. And then I could use that and change the resolution to be higher than my built-in webcam. So I'll go ahead and minimize this for now. You also could share your screen. So you could do this when you're live, and you could do this if you're using this as a video conferencing platform. I'll show you that in a second. You have a chat box available to you, and you could schedule this for a later time. So if you want to schedule a broadcast for a later time, you could set this up here. I'll show you live streaming in a second. Right at the end of the video, I'm going to show you how to use this as just a video conferencing platform where you're not live and you're just meeting with one person. Much easier than things like Zoom, where you got to install it on your computer. If I just press go live here, basically what you could do with this platform is you could stream directly to YouTube, to Facebook, to LinkedIn. There's more options, Twitch. And the one really unique thing about it is you could stream to all of them at the same time. It's called multi-stream if you want to set that up. So you don't have to link any of these accounts that you want to do this with. So let me go ahead and link a YouTube account so I could show you that whole process. So one of my YouTube accounts has been set up here. For the sake of this video, I'm going to change this to unlisted since I don't want to go live on a public channel right now, but you can. But since I'm just showing you how to do this, I'm going to press the check mark and it's set up. Now set up as many of these as you like and select at least one, and then press next on here. So give it a title, give it a description, press go live. And if your YouTube account is not set up for live streaming, make sure you check that and make sure it's turned on. So let me go ahead and do that. So jump into your YouTube channel and press this option right here and press go live. Your channel has to be verified here. And if you've never been on here before, go ahead and set this up. And this is different on Facebook and Twitch, obviously, but I'm gonna set this up right here. And once it's set up, you could actually go live from here. So let me go ahead and show myself on screen, and you can see a countdown up here, and it's gonna show me right here on the screen. Now, all your stream chats will show up here. Your private chats will show on this side, pretty straightforward here. You could always edit the screen. And you have a ton of options, like you could go ahead and add the themes, for example, like this. You could see that changes some of your graphics here. You have some design options where you could change the font. Let me go back here. You could add a logo here. So that's the logo that will appear over here. You could add video. So I could do videos like this and do these type of countdowns with music here. Now, I just brought a pop-up green screen. It's not covering the whole background, but I just want to show you this in action. So if you go over here and turn on green screen, I'm going to press understand, and then go to the settings of that. The default option lets you pick from one of these options for your background. So if you choose a different image, for example, you could go ahead and press OK. And I'm using a terrible camera right here, so you definitely want a better webcam. But you could see it's doing a good job, and you could always change the fade over here. Now, I have no light on that green screen, and it's kind of too close to me. But you get the idea. If you have a nice big green screen here that covers the background, you could choose any image as your background, especially with the paid upgrades. Now, for live streaming, let me show you what it would look like if you shared your screen. So if I press share screen here and choose one of my screens here, I'll choose a window in this case, and I'll just choose the project I'm editing right now. So let's say I was doing a demo of that. It's going to show up just like another user here on the left side. I'll show it on screen here, and this is what it's going to look like. I'm still going to be on screen, and my window is going to look like this. And if I change the layout, I could actually change it over here. So if I want a different layout, this one is very popular where you're on the side. Again, you could turn on the green screen function over here too. So if I wanted to do that and put myself somewhere else, I could still do that being a different environment. Again, upgrade your camera if you're gonna do this green screen effect. Anytime when I wanna finish my stream here, I could just press end stream and end it right from here. Then the ability to invite guests. Look how easy this is. You just press right here, invite a guest. And then you just send them this link. I'm gonna copy this link and I'm gonna paste it. And this is what the other person is gonna see when they paste it. They're gonna get a window like this. They could type in their name, set up their microphone, set up their camera, and all the same inputs, and then join. And then it's gonna let them join. And it can't be any easier to invite someone on a chat. And what's great about that is when you're doing this, you don't actually have to go live. I'm showing you the live streaming, but you don't have to live stream. You could actually use this to record and use it as a video conferencing platform too. So I just send that link to myself. I clicked it on an email and here it is on my phone. So if I show that second person, this is the guest, I'm showing both of myself here. So let me actually turn off the camera. So now I'm having a normal meeting. And what's great about it is if you look on the bottom here, you actually have different layouts too. So you could change your layout so fast and easy. And then you could use these themes, right? And change how the background looks. So these are something that are gonna be much more complicated with other platforms. One of my favorite things is this kind of a layout where the background could be a different color and your guest and your host could be like this. And you could invite multiple people. Now, this is where we're gonna get into some of the plans that are upgrade from the free plan. So let me show you that. So for example, if I go live here, and I'm not going live, I'm trying to just do a record only. If I turn this on, basically there is a free option that I'm showing you right now. But with the standard package too, you won't have any watermarks. You could have up to 6 participants and you could have unlimited streams. And then there's a pro version too, where it gives you a lot more options like 10 hours of recording and up to 9 participants. So you could explore these and get the paid upgrade if you want. I'm just using the free version here just to show you what's going on. Very, very simple, very easy to set up. And from all the platforms that I've tested out over the last 18 months, this is one of the easiest, if not the easiest one I ever seen. I did not even have to sign up from another account to join the meeting. I didn't have to do anything to set up the stream besides connecting my account. I didn't have to have any technical knowledge. So I wanted to thank Melon for sponsoring this video. I'm doing another video just dedicated to mobile on my app channel. So make sure you check that out in the description below once it's released. Thanks so much for watching this video. Please give it a thumbs up. I will see you next time.